This is an instructional video on how to use the Droplet Lab Contact Angle app. First, we create a new account. Choose the username and password. Confirm password. And security question for password recovery. After creating an account or signing in, create a project. This includes the project name, the image calibration number, which is the outside diameter of the needle being used in the experiment. We recommend that you measure the diameter of the needle with a micrometer before starting the experiment to ensure proper calibration. If you are using the polynomial method, you do not need this value. The differential density is the density difference between the liquid and its outer gas or liquid. In this case, we are doing water and air, so we can leave it at its default value. In case you are doing liquid and liquid measurements, for example, oil and water, the value will be the density of oil being used, minus the density of water. And finally, the acceleration of gravity. The default value is 9.8. If you wish to provide a more precise value, you can select the injection mode depending on if you ordered the automatic dispenser hardware add-on. Click on the newly created project and enter image capture screen. We now put the phone inside the phone holder. Click on the blue image capture button and adjust the distance from the needle. We manipulate the orange box to select the area of interest. Use the focus slider to focus on the droplet. To get the best results, the focus slider should ideally be as close to the maximum value possible. The aim is to be as close to the droplet as possible without losing focus. Adjust the LED backlight and the phone's light to get the best possible contrast between the droplet and the background. Generate a test droplet to help calibrate the image settings. The camera focus should be on the droplet, not the surface edge or the needle. Hit the capture button once you are satisfied with the settings. The polynomial algorithm can measure left and right contact angles separately. Needle can be inside or outside the droplet. The default method is smart contact points. Here, user only needs to provide an estimate for the baseline and left-right contact points. The system then auto-detects the exact contact points. When selecting the baseline, be careful to not mistake the droplet for its reflection. This can be a problem with contact angles around 90 degrees. Hit calculate once everything is in position. The Young-Laplace method is the recommended method for axisymmetric drops. It will average out the difference between left and right contact angles. Unlike the polynomial method, needle has to be outside the droplet, and we need to do the calibration process to use this method. Move the orange points to the left and right of the needle and hit calibrate. An initial estimate is enough. If the calibration number is green, then the number is correct. If it's red or yellow, then something is wrong. We suggest you recheck the diameter of the needle in the project screen and redo the calibration process. Generally, the lower the calibration number, the better. Now we will demonstrate how to use multi-capture for dynamic contact angle measurement. The app's multi-capture function can be used to take multiple images in a set time frame. The maximum frames per second without an SD card in the phone is 10 FPS. Simply specify the number of images to capture and the duration of capture. Once you are ready, hit the capture button and start generating the droplet. Go to one of the images. Do the entire calculation process including calibration. If using the Young-Laplace method, then go back and hit calculate all to process all the images captured in this time frame. After completing on calculation in a series of images, the rest of the images can be automatically calculated from the project screen if all the settings were the same for each image. In case smart contact points does not work, there are two alternate methods that user can use. Manual. This forces the measurement where the user decides. Extended. This is an alternative algorithm. Extended uses more of the droplet profile to find contact angle. A few features that are accessed from the project screen. The project parameters can be edited. You can load external images into the project. You can also run a video slideshow of the images in the project in chronological order. The calculated data can be saved per your preference. In settings, you can choose if you want to store the data on the SD card. You can also choose to save on your preferred cloud service. We currently support Google Drive, Dropbox, Microsoft OneDrive and Box. We also allow you to easily report an issue from within the app via email. To archive a project, long press the project and hit Archive. Archived projects can be accessed from the settings screen.
Visit our website to learn more.